Welcome to Quick and Loans Arena in Cleveland, Ohio. It's Wednesday night NBA, presented by ESPN on EA Sports, as we get set for the second meeting of the season between the Cleveland Cavaliers and the Oklahoma City Thunder. As this one gets underway, Jeff, who might they need to be careful with against Cleveland tonight?
Well, it's got to be Kyrie Irving, one of the most efficient point guards in the league. Shoots a high percentage.
Let's go! Yo, what is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. DDG here, and I told you, motherfucker! I told him! They said I was delusional. They said I don't have any common sense. They said I don't know what I'm talking about. The game's not delayed. It's delayed. It's not canceled. It's delayed. You gotta give it a chance, bro. Why you always hating, bro? Why you always this? Why you always that? Bitch! Who was hating? Who was hating? I was right all along! Who was hating? Who? Who? Who was fucking hating, bruh? Who was hating? Not me. I was spitting nothing but facts. From the fucking jump, bruh. But I'm hating? Trey? Nah, bruh. There was never no hate over here. It was nothing. I don't hate NBA Live. I just gotta call out bullshit when I see bullshit. And I saw bullshit. And I pointed it out. And I said, And I warned y'all. I forewarned y'all, dog. I forewarned y'all, bruh. I told you niggas the game was gonna get canceled. I told you, it was going to happen. It was either going to happen by the end of January or sometime in February. Around that time, when it gets close to the All-Star break, they're going to cancel it, and they're going to release it in the fall. I told you this, and what the fuck just happened? I predicted this shit, and they did it in the exact way I knew they was gonna do it. EA is so fucking predictable, bruh. And you niggas fell for it. How do you feel knowing that you are not going to get NBA Live 17 when I told you it wasn't coming out? Didn't I tell y'all it was going to get canceled? Didn't I tell you it wasn't gonna come out? I told you niggas from the fucking jump, it's not coming out. In the fall, it'll come out. If it don't come out in the fall, then shit, they just need to give up at that point. I warned you niggas. I told you niggas. I tried to save you. I tried to really be there for y'all, man. But y'all just didn't want to believe it, man. Y'all wanted to believe your own hype. You wanted me to be wrong. And what the fuck happened, ladies and gentlemen? NBA Live 17 is what? Canceled. It's canceled. It's not delayed. It's not fucking coming out by All-Star break, which was the dumbest fucking idea of all time. Because how the fuck in the world are they going to do? How the fuck you going to take that much time? Knowing goddamn good and well. This game ain't never fully polished when it first comes out. NBA Live is never fully polished when it first comes out. It gets better when the patches come out. That's what makes the game better when the patches come out. When it comes out in the early stages, it's glitchy as fuck. The player models, they got to upgrade the player models and shit. Remember how long that patch took to get fucking Karl Anthony Towns and fucking Jahlil Okafor's face into the game? Remember that? Remember how long it took to get all the fucking rookies' faces correct and shit? And certain NBA players, remember that? Remember how long, how many patches was that? I think it was about 3 or 4, wasn't it? 3 or 4 patches. I think no, it was patch 3. I think it was patch 3 or patch 4. It was one of them patches, and I fucking sat there and I fucking said, finally they fixed the fucking shit. They finally fixed all this shit, all these gameplay issues, all these other mechanics that need to be fixed, the player models and everything else. They finally fixed that shit, bro. How long did it fucking take? Do you know how long it would took? We would have been in the NBA Finals by the time they had fully polished the game, bro. And that's facts, bro. We would have had to wait all the way to the All-Star break. And y'all niggas want to sit up here and be like, it's going to come out. You just hate. No, EA fag boy. There was no hate. It was only facts, baby. Ain't no hate over here. I ain't got no hate against him yet, Live. I'm just saying, though, bro. It ain't coming out. I don't fall for the bullshit unlike y'all. And now that y'all, now who looking stupid? Who looking stupid? You, bitch. That's who looking stupid right now. All you EA fag boys out there that's looking stupid right now. Oh my god. Y'all looking so fucking stupid. And I done told y'all I was the only person in the NBA Live community saying this shit. I was spitting nothing but straight facts. But everybody and their mama talking about, it's gonna come out. You don't know what you're talking about. Stop hating on me. Ain't no hate, bruh. It was nothing but facts, baby. Nothing but facts. You can't deny it. Everything I said happened. I said when we get close to All-Star break, what's going to happen? They're going to cancel it. What happened? They canceled it. All-Star break is on. The All-Star break is on. What, the 15th? The 15th or the 16th, I believe. I believe it's the 16th, right? All-Star break starts on the 16th of this month. Today is the 1st. You're telling me they're going to have a game ready by then? Get the fuck out of here, yo. If they did come out the game, it'd probably have to come out by the time the playoffs come around. And that's fucking stupid. Because they were not going to come out the game not this late in the fucking season, bruh. It was already too late in the season, bruh. The latest you could possibly get the game out was possibly by Christmas. That's the latest you could possibly get an NBA game out because it's still a little early in the season. By Christmas time. That's the one I would say. But All-Star break? No, it's too late by then because we know who the MVP is. We know who the good teams are. We know the teams to look out for. We know what's going to happen. We know all this shit, bro. We know everything about the league that we need to know, bro. Y'all fell for this shit. Y'all the ones looking stupid. Y'all the ones sitting up here, no, it's canceled. My feelings are hurt. And I told you, bro. I tried to warn you 2K niggas, too. Y'all 2K niggas put too much hope into this fucking game. And I tried to forewarn y'all. As a nigga who don't even fuck with 2K and don't fuck with NBA Live either, but I prefer to be a part of the NBA Live community because I feel like I'm the only person on here that's actually doing this shit. I took a hiatus, but that's only because my PS4 is down. I'm back now. Oh, yeah, I'm back now. And I'm talking hella shit, okay? Because, first off, you bitches sat up here since... When the fuck did NBA Live get canceled? When they announced that it got canceled, okay? Y'all talking about delayed? No, it got announced that it was canceled, okay? I still say it was canceled, bro. And it's canceled because there's no NBA Live 17 coming out, bro. Bro, do y'all not understand? Y'all don't think, bro. Y'all not really looking at the big picture. You just being a fanboy. You're not looking into the realisticness of this. Okay, you have to be realistic about it. You have to think about it. They have to get player ratings, rookie faces.
It's time for the Rose Report at halftime, and it's brought to you by EA Sports.
Animations.
The Thunder are in a tight
stats. Because they do the NBA rewind stuff. Then you got the Ultimate Team. You know how many fucking moments they done missed out on? How many special cards they could have had? By now, bruh, you know how many cards they done missed out on? They done missed out on about at least like They probably missed out on at least about like 40, like 40 to damn near 50 cards, special moment cards. Russell Westbrook and all his triple doubles, James Harden 50 point triple double games and shit. Joel Embiid, Jabari Parker, Giannis Antetokounmpo, fucking Kyrie, Kawhi. You know what I'm saying? It's too many fucking players doing too much crazy shit this season, bruh. And it's too late in the season now to even consider dropping a video game. Unless it's NBA Jam or NBA Street. That's your only two options at this point. Only two options I can see is NBA Jam or NBA Street. If you're not dropping NBA Jam or NBA Street, or if you're not just gonna update the fucking roster for the game that's right in front of us right now, then why the fuck would you come out with a new game? A new NBA Live? For what? You might as well just update this shit. Add in the roster. Charge us about $5. I'll pay $5 for a new roster, okay? I ain't tripping, bro. I'll pay $5 for a new roster in this game. I ain't tripping, bro. The game will still be trash. Just give us some new Pro-Am courts. Give us an updated roster. Charge us $5 for the whole fucking shebang-a-bang. You know what I'm saying? And it would be straight. It would be cool. It would be straight. It would be a whole new season. You know what I'm saying? You give us some new commentary from Jeff Green. Jeff Green. Jeff Van Gundy. Mike Breen. It's Mike Breen. Not Jeff Green. But Mike Breen. Jeff Van Gundy. Mark Jackson. You have to add Mark Jackson. If you're going to have the ESPN crew, you cannot have the ESPN crew without Mark Jackson. It just don't feel right. You need Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy arguing with each other throughout the whole rest of the game. Because that's what makes it feel like an actual game you're watching on ESPN. Not just the presentation and scoreboard. You need Mark Jackson there too. That's what gives it the realistic feel. Then you need Jalen Rose, Chauncey Billups. You need those two to do the halftime show. I don't give a fuck about Michelle Beadle. I don't give a fuck about her. She Dick Ryder Spurs too much. I don't like that shit. I don't like Dick Ryder too much, okay? I like unbiased people, all right? I need unbiased reporters out here. I don't need Dick Ryders, okay? I hate Dick Ryders. I hate him. I hate Ben Wagner's and I hate Dick Ryders. But, yeah. I told you. Big fella, I told him the game was coming out, big fella. They wasn't listening, big fella. Now look how they looking, big fella. They looking stupid, big fella. Big fella, what I look, big fella, I look like a prophet right now, bro. Like a prophet, nigga. I predicted this shit, nigga. I told you niggas this game wasn't coming out, bro. What y'all want to say? What y'all want to do?
It's coming out. It's coming out. You just got to wait on it's going to come. The bitch is not coming out.
Y'all not looking at it logically, bruh. Logically, when I saw that shit, logically, I said, they're canceling that shit. They're going to wait till July and cancel that shit. I thought they was going to put out some screenshots. They didn't even put out no fucking screenshots. They ain't give us a trailer. They ain't give us nothing, bro. And they talking about they working hard on this game. Really, bitch? Really, bitch? Really? Really? Mitch, please. No, you not working on this game. If you was working on this game, we would have at least saw some development. Some development. You got to be real right now. Do you really think they really working hard on this game right now? Don't you think we deserve to see some development, some screenshots, some something? We deserve to see something. You can't hide everything. If they were serious about this shit, they would at least drop some screenshots, don't you think? I mean, come on now. They didn't drop nothing on Christmas. When they didn't drop nothing around Christmas time, that's when I knew this shit was finna be a wrap, bruh. I knew this shit was finna be a wrap. I kept it on the back of my mind. I was like, you know what? It's around Christmas time and ain't no NBA Live content out. I was like, damn, that's kind of sad, bruh. That's kind of sad, bruh. We ain't got no NBA Live content. I ain't talking about this game supposed to come out around in All-Star break. All the 2K niggas, bruh. All the 2K niggas that was hyping this shit up, bruh. Oh, yeah, man. NBA Live gonna kill it, man. How y'all feel now? Didn't I tell y'all, motherfucker? I tried to warn you. Y'all ain't want to listen. Y'all 2K niggas, y'all fell for it too. Y'all looking just as stupid as the EA fag boys right now, man. And y'all the 2K niggas, bro. Y'all some traitors too. Y'all some 2K niggas. Y'all some traitors, bro. Stick to your motherfucking group, bro. Stick to your motherfucking group, nigga. You know 2K is your shit. You know what I'm saying? That's all you play all day, every day, bro. Y'all be sitting up here complaining and shit. Y'all be like, man, fuck this shit. Fuck this shit. We dead servers and all this other shit. Park at the door. Man, fuck all this shit, nigga. I don't even fuck this shit no more, cuz. They got us wasting our money and shit on this motherfucking packs and shit, nigga. And we ain't getting nothing but fucking beast busted ass gold players and shit, bro. I wasted like $200, bro, on packs, bro. I need some motherfucking cards, nigga. What the fuck, man? Y'all sitting up here playing, but y'all still playing the same fucking game. Stick to y'all fucking group, bro. That's y'all. Don't try to jump over on this NBA Live shit. You know what I'm saying? Don't try to jump up here. Y'all some motherfucking traitors, bro. Y'all some... Y'all be sitting up... Y'all be... You know what I... Y'all the niggas that was talking shit about Kevin Durant when he went to the Warriors. But you go jump ship to NBA Live and shit. Now look how you looking. Now you looking stupid. Now you looking stupid. Okay? Now Kevin Durant doesn't win a ring. Then he looking stupid. But if Kevin Durant wins a ring, he ain't looking so stupid, okay? He got a ring, bitch. He like, look at the ring, bitch. Y'all ain't got nothing to say, bro. Like, that's all I'm saying, bro. Y'all the same niggas who talk shit about Kevin Durant, not about Kevin Durant being a pussy for joining the Golden State Warriors. But if he win a ring, you ain't got nothing to really say. But y'all niggas, on the other hand, all y'all 2K niggas that jump shit to NBA Live trying to be cool and shit. How you feel, bro? How that L feel? Hold this L, bro. Hold this L. This L is for everybody, bro. This L is for the NBA Live community, the 2K niggas that try to jump over into the NBA Live community, all the niggas in my comment section for the longest that's been telling me the game was not delayed. It wasn't. The game was delayed and not canceled. This L is for all y'all, bro. Everybody holds this motherfucking L, B. Everybody gets this L, B. Everybody gets this L, B. This L is for everybody. This L is for everybody. Everybody gets this L, bro. Your mama, your daddy, your grandma, your auntie, your uncle. I'm gonna fuck it, they dead. All you niggas holding this L, bro. Your dead relatives, they can hold this L in their grave, bro. I don't give a fuck right now. I'm doing some disrespectful shit. I don't give a fuck, bro. Everybody holding this motherfucking L. Because I'm tired of shit. I had to deal with all this shit for the past couple of months. And I told you niggas. I forewarned you niggas. I said, if NBA Live gets canceled, y'all gonna feel my motherfucking wrath. Because I'm handing out L's. I'm gonna let y'all niggas know straight up. All y'all niggas looking stupid now. How y'all feel, bruh? How it feel? Everybody hold this big ass L, bruh. Hold that big ass L. How that L feel, bruh? Just hold it, bruh. It's just one big ass L for y'all to hold, bruh. It don't feel good, do it. But neither did it feel good when I was getting bullshit. For the simple fact that I was spitting nothing but facts, bro. I told y'all niggas, bro. Didn't I tell y'all niggas that this game was not gonna come out? Just look at the timing of the game and look where the season would be by the time the game came out. It doesn't make sense to come out that late. Unless it's an NBA Jam or an NBA Street. That's the only logical way you could go about this, bro. Y'all niggas had y'all hopes up and shit. Man, y'all ain't getting no motherfucking NBA Live 17, bruh. If it wasn't coming out in fall, if it wasn't coming out around Christmas time, it ain't coming out at all, bruh. And that's a motherfucking fact, dog. Get the fuck out of here, EA. Get the fuck out of here, EA Fagboys. All y'all niggas hold this motherfucking L, bruh. Hold this motherfucking L, bruh. I need all you niggas to hold this motherfucking L, bruh. Every single one of y'all hold this L. I never gave in to the hype, bruh. I never give in to hype. I don't fall for that shit, bruh. I stick to my gut because I feel what I know. I might not be right all the time, but when I'm spit, but I know bullshit when I see it, okay? That's the one thing about me. In the words of Cash Nasty, you can't finesse a motherfucking finesse, baby. You can't finesse a motherfucking finesse. You can't finesse me. I'm the finesse god, nigga. I finesse plenty of people throughout my lifetime, nigga. You can't finesse me, EA. You can't finesse me, bro. I'm not as gullible as everybody else. You can't finesse me, bro.
Nice job.
It'll never happen. It'll never happen.
Irving against Westbrook.
But it's cool though. It's cool. I just really feel happy right now. I feel so happy right now because y'all gotta hold this big ass L. You gotta hold it, bruh. Y'all did it to yourselves. Believing in this company, man. You know EA ain't gonna come through. I knew EA wasn't gonna come through. You should have knew EA wasn't gonna come through. Everybody and their mama should have knew EA wasn't gonna come through. I stated this shit. And I told you. It's gonna get canceled. And what the fuck happened? It got canceled. So hold this L. Hold it. Firmly grasp it in your hand. Firmly grasp it. Just firmly grasp it, bruh. Firmly grasp this L in your hand. Just take it, bruh. You ain't got no choice. All these niggas talking shit on Twitter and shit. Sitting, putting my name out there to other YouTubers that play NBA Live and shit. To tell you the truth, them niggas was saying the same shit I was saying low-key. Because they started to doubt the shit when, when nothing wasn't popping up, bruh. They log on every day. Ain't nothing coming out, bruh. They like, damn, bruh, when this NBA Live coming out, it's like we working on it. Damn, can we get some screenshots? Can we get a trailer or something? Like, even if, like, 9 times out of 10, if you really working hard on a video game, you gonna show at least some progress of the game. Like, think about it, bro. When NBA, think about this game. Think about NBA Live 16, bro. Think about how hard they went, bro. They came out strong at E3 that year, bro. Y'all remember that shit. They came out strong at E3, bro. They was talking hella shit. They was talking about, we got reliable servers, nigga. We got better animations, nigga. You know what? Right now, we gonna show. They was showing the game in this alpha, bro. Pre-alpha, bro. They showed the game in pre-alpha and let niggas play it at E3. The demos there at E3, they let IGN record gameplay and show it to the fucking world, bro. That's how you know they're commit. That's how you know they was ready for this shit, bro. It looked like EA was ready to take the crown, bro, but then they sold 10,000 units and fell off.
Able to convert on both free throws.
So think about it, bro. If they was really working hard in this game, don't you think we would have saw some screenshots by now? They didn't hesitate on NBA Live 16. They damn sure didn't hesitate. They dropped that shit out immediately. They said, we ain't gonna hide no gameplay from y'all. If y'all want some gameplay, we'll give you some gameplay. We'll drop a trailer. We'll drop everything. Nigga, they hyped the fuck out of this game, bruh. Pro-Am. They hyped up the Pro-Am shit. And then as soon as 2K dropped their Pro-Am shit, EA was like, nah, fuck that, nigga. Here you go. He was like, nah, fuck that, nigga. Are y'all bringing back crew mode? Okay, well, guess what, nigga? Dropping this motherfucking Pro-Am on your bitch asses, nigga. And this shit, it was like, bro, they was ready for this shit, bro. They was ready for this shit. We ain't got a screenshot, not a motherfucking cover athlete, not a now. I don't know what I'm saying, but it sound good, don't it? not a now. Y'all know it like I know it, man. They ain't doing nothing with this game, man. It's probably gonna be the same old shit you looking at right now, dog. Cause if they was really working on this game, you would have saw some screenshots. You would have at least saw some alpha gameplay. They would have at least tried to make it seem like they was actually going to attempt to try to bring it out around All-Star break. Dog, they wasn't coming out the shit. The pressure build up and they folded under the pressure, bruh. They do this all the fucking time. When the game gets hyped up and the pressure is on, they have a tendency to fold. they give up and then they just put out whatever when they put out whatever when you're not really expecting the most out of them. EA, they do this, bro. These NBA Live devs, they done this, bro. This ain't our first go around. Y'all should know better by now. NBA Elite, it got canceled in terms. They only dropped the mobile version and canceled the console version. Remember that? Then NBA Live 12, then NBA Elite 12 or NBA Live 12 didn't even get announced. Wasn't even in consideration for being put into production. Then they start hyping up NBA Live 13. What happened? They canceled that shit. Then we all know what happened NBA Live 14. We know how that shit turned out. We ain't even gonna talk about that. We ain't gonna talk about NBA Live 14 now. We gonna bury that one. We gonna bury that one like that bitch on fire and toss it. We gonna light that bitch into oblivion. We don't remember that shit. NBA Live 15 came out. It was fucking good. Then this shit came out and then it was like, it was fucking shit until they patched it up. Then it got better. I will admit, it got better when they started patching up the game. But outside of that, the game was pretty much mediocre compared to what they did in NBA Live 15. But that's another story for another day, though. So, basically, the point that I'm trying to get at, y'all, is I deserve a fucking apology. I want a fucking apology. I want everybody in the comment section to say, I am sorry. I am sorry, Mr. DDG94. I am sorry for coming at you in a very disrespectful manner. I want my motherfucking respect. I want y'all to put some respect on it, okay? Y'all gonna put some respect on my name. I'm not gonna say it no more. I ain't playing no more, okay? I want some respect on my motherfucking name. I ain't saying it no more. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm pulling up on you, nigga. I'm pulling up on you. Ain't no Trick Daddy. Ain't no Rick Ross. Ain't no Rick Ross. Ain't no Trick Daddy. I'm pulling up on you, nigga. I'm pulling up on you. Put some respect on my name. All three of y'all. All 3,000 of y'all. All 3,000,000 of y'all. I want some respect on my motherfucking name because I told y'all this shit and it fucking happened. I want my motherfucking respect. The NBA Live community, you need me. You need me. You ain't got nobody else. Everybody else is a dick rider. I'm the only nigga that criticizes this game and keeps it real. Everybody else dick rides this shit and try to be like, oh, okay, you know what I'm saying? This gonna happen. It's gonna get better as time goes. Nah, bro, you need a nigga in the community that's gonna keep it real, bro. Whether it's the 2K community, the NBA Live community, you need somebody in this motherfucker to keep it real with you. You can't have all these fucking yes men running around and shit. They ain't really saying shit. They just like, eh, shit happens. Bitch, what? Shit happens. No, motherfucker, I'll pay $60 for this game. I deserve better content, don't I? But I'm going to leave it right there for right now. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I feel like I deserve a fucking apology. All you EA fag boys, I deserve an apology, bro. I know y'all wasn't ready for this. Y'all wasn't ready for it. Y'all knew it was coming, but y'all just wasn't ready. Because it hit y'all so fast. It was like, oh, shit. And everybody go cut in my channel going to be like, oh, shit. This nigga finna get it going. You goddamn right, motherfucker. I'm going to get it going. I'm going to tell you ass. Put some respect on my motherfucking name. I'm not going to say it no more. Put some motherfucking respect on my motherfucking name. Mr. DDG94 deserves a motherfucking apology. Right fucking now. I want a motherfucking apology. I want everybody to state the motherfucking facts that this game is canceled. And we're going to have to wait for NBA Live 18, not 17. Stupid motherfuckers. But that's about it. I'm going to leave it right here. I got more videos. I got more videos. I got more shit to talk. I got plenty of motherfucking videos. We got all the time in the world, ladies and gentlemen. We got all the time in the world. We got a long way to go to the fall. We got a long way to go to the fall, baby. This just video number one. This just video number one. Video number uno, dos. NBA number uno, cuz. You know what I'm saying, ese? This only uno, ese. That's about it, though. I'll see you on the next video. hold this L, hold it firmly, and I'll see you on the next video. Till then, peace out, bitches.